Good morning, y'all. What is up? What is up? What is up? It's your boy Chance. As you can tell, I got my camera gear on. I got my bag that I usually carry my gear in. I got my tripod and my camera charging. It's actually at 82% right now. I got my Kindle charged up. I just wanted to know, as far as like me doing vlogging, because I am trying to get back into vlogging, doing daily vlogs here and there for my vlog channel. And I wanted to know what you guys would like to see me do. Like, do you guys want to see me do some more urban exploration? Do you guys want to go into the railroad tracks, get some video of that? Do you guys want to see me do some skateboarding? Like, what do you guys want to see me do? If you guys don't know, this also does double up as my gaming rig for, controller cam and wheel cam. I just attached it to this, as you guys saw. But I did make an adjustment to it. Instead of using the chain like I was, I have these right here for support. They're actually really good. So I wound up making that adjustment to this, which is awesome. But I am getting ready to go out here in a bit and do some vlogging. Like, I wanted to know, what you guys wanted to, see me do. Like, what's something that you guys have not seen me do yet that you'd like to see me do? Like, is it skating? Is it grabbing my bike and doing some crazy stuff? Like, what do you guys want to see? Because, when it comes to vlogging, there's nothing I can't really do. I can definitely do that.
Oh yeah, it's much better up here. Chance?
Yeah.
Here, let me turn the heat off.
Alright, give me just a minute, guys. I'll be right back. No, 1 minute, guys, I'll be right there. Alright, sorry about that, y'all. What's up? I am back. I tried to turn the heat off because it got super hot. As for the bike, I will be able to do that as soon as I get air in my tires. One of the tires is actually flat right now. I just gotta get some air in it. But since y'all are awesome enough and every single one of you guys has been here with me on this journey, I do have something I'm gonna show you guys. I'm actually gonna show you guys the board that I use every time I do these vlogs. Like, the kind of board I got is actually really hard to get your hands on nowadays. So you guys are getting the first look at one of the rarest boards I've ever owned. So give me just 1 minute. Now, if you guys don't know, this board has been used a bit by me, but this is like one of the last ones of its kind, which is this right here. This is one of the last boards that Tony Hawk himself actually made before he retired from skating, which is, boom, the Tony Hawk Huck Jam series board. As you can tell, it has been used a bit. I have done tricks on it here and there. But this is like literally one of the last ones that he ever made. And believe it or not, my mom's actually the one that found this on the side of the road one day. So I got pretty damn lucky. And you got the riot trucks right there, man, as you guys can tell. I don't know if you guys can tell me if you look. Right there, it says Riot up in there. You got the Riot trucks with the gold Tony Hawk wheel pieces. And if y'all don't know, yes, I'm a skater. And I've watched all the X Games. I still watch X Games. So right, y'all, just downloading Skateboard Putty 3 onto my Chromebook so I can have some footage to shoot for you guys when I get back. But this is literally like one of the last of its kind. So like, I was super lucky to get my hands on this board. As you can tell, I do need to get some street wheels for it though, because like these wheels are meant for like actual skate parks and stuff. Like, they are good, not gonna lie. They are good for skating, but they're not street wheels. They're actually, as you can tell, they're like the vert ramp skate park wheels. So I do need to eventually get some new stuff for these. I do need to get some new wheels, which those will be easy to change out because I got the wrenches and stuff in my toolbox. I can just switch those out. But this is probably my rarest and most prized possession board. Like, this is the board that I ride all the time. Like, whether I'm going up to a school, up to a store, or going to a hill bomb, going downhill down here, because there's a nice little S-shaped hill that I like to ride down. Now, I do have it set up to where it does lean. So, I, whenever I ride, I'm able to kind of move with the board, kind of like I'm surfing. As you can tell, definitely needs clean. The grip tape does need clean. If you guys can't tell, there is a star set right there. Like, that's pretty fucking dope. Like, I noticed that not that long ago, so. But, I mean, I do have some other, too, like, the Mongoose Swift Justice, which is more or less your common boards. Like, that's one of your more common ones that a lot of people use. Mongoose is a good brand of board, though. I do also have a Mongoose street bike. It's not a BMX bike, it's just your regular, you know, street style bike with pegs, which I don't use the pegs that much because, basically, who uses pegs anymore? I mean, those are like early 2000s, 90s type shit. I mean, a lot of people do still use them, just not me. But as soon as I get new air in my tires, I definitely will be doing some pretty cool stunts with my bike, because I have been doing bike stunts for a while. I actually grew up doing them since I was a kid. You know, just watching like X Games, learning how to do the different stuff, like the seat stand, everything like that. So I am looking forward to a good time. And I will be biking and vlogging at the same time, just as well as skating and vlogging. I do plan on doing that. But if you guys don't know, I do. If you guys are wondering what I use for my rig, this is what I'm actually going to show you guys, the basic setup that I use like for my chest rig for whenever I'm gaming out, for those of you that are gamers and you guys want a pretty cool, neat little setup that's easy to do. Like, all you really need is a like a bendy tripod like this, like a bendable, flexy, tripod. Like, all you need is that and your phone and something like this, like a backpack. But me, I use this because it's flat, so it's not like bulging out and I'm not getting crushed or pressed against the straps. This is more or less flat, so it's slim, easy to use. But what I do is I attach this to here. Like, I attach it across here. I attach the two sides. I attach these two right here. I attach these two side ones right here to the sides, and then this one right here, this front one sticking out. I'll attach that to right here. And then what I'll do is I'll go into my phone, and then I'll flip my camera on to where, as you guys can tell, it's got this view right there. So what I'll do is I'll have it facing me. Like, I'll have it facing, like, as you can tell, I got the outer camera facing you guys right now, not the inner camera. This side of the camera, I'll have it facing outward. That way I can see what's going on as I'm doing it. So I'll be able to look down and see what I'm doing. So I'll have it attached here, and I'll be able to see my hands like this right here. And just go from there. So if you guys are into gaming and you want a good setup for a wheel cam or a, controller cam like what I do, get yourself a bendy tripod. They're only a couple bucks a piece. They're not that expensive. I do plan on getting a bigger one though for my Kindle as soon as I get the money. There are a couple big ones I am looking at. And also, shout out to everybody that does have birthdays today, man. And I do also want to say thank you to everyone that did wish me a happy birthday on my birthday. I don't know if I got around to saying that or not, but thank you guys. If I didn't, it's because I've been super busy the last few weeks. There have been a slight change in plans as far as me working this next weekend coming up. This weekend I won't be working. It'll actually be the weekend after due to my mom not having a car yet. So, hey, Seahawks beat Dallas, dude. Sorry, Greg. Y'all don't know, man. I'm a hardcore Seahawks fan. That's my home team. Like, win or lose, I'm always gonna be a Seahawks fan till I die, like, straight up. So what up to all my Seahawks fans out there? What up to the 12-man army? Legion of Boom. See you guys. What's up to all my Hawk Nation out there? Fucking love you guys. Greg, I know you're just giving me a hard time, dude. I know you're giving me a hard time, Greg, but you're awesome for it though, dude. But like I said, guys, I got some big stuff planned. Now that I got a tripod, I'm able to do a little bit more. I don't always have to be holding my camera with both hands or one hand being way out here, down here. I can actually sit down and just be like, boom. Like, I can do some cool shit. Like, this definitely will allow for some cool ass footage, especially once I get my bike. I can really do some cool stuff. And no, I'm not going to attempt to attach this to my skateboard wheels because I don't want to fucking break the damn thing. So don't even get any ideas about me attaching this to my board because it ain't gonna work. Hey, L Riggers, what's up? And I do apologize if I'm pronouncing that wrong. So if I am pronouncing it wrong, please let me know. Like I said, guys, I do have some big stuff planned for not only today, but for the next few days while it's nice out before it gets cold. I am going to be doing some vlogging, like I said. I may do some urban exploration as well. I don't know. But, like I said, guys, like now that you guys that are gamers and y'all know how to do the setup like I do, it's not that hard. It's fairly simple. But, like I said, a lot of people don't know that, yes, I am a skater, and this board right here, the Tony Hawk Cup Jam Series board, one of the rarest of the boards out there to date, due to one of the last ones being manufactured by the Birdman, Tony Hawk himself. This is definitely my prize board right here. Like, this is my baby right here. Like, this is my prize board right here. Like, this is, I would kill for this fucking board. And I would eventually like signed, actually. Like, I've always wanted to have that board signed and put up, like, once it gets used out and done. I do eventually want to, get the man, Tony Hawk himself, to actually sign that, which would be super cool. I've played all the games. I've grew up, I grew up watching them as a kid. Hey, what up, Greg? And hey, Greg, I know you're just joking around with me about the Cowboys and stuff, man. I know you're giving me a hard time, dude. But no hard feelings, though, man. Yo, Clayton, what's up, dude? Long time no see, my man. How you been? But like I said, guys, as far as working this next weekend, those plans did change a little bit, so I won't be making as much due to my mom not having a car up until next weekend. Not this weekend coming up, but the weekend after. But if you guys are in the Cuyahoga Falls area near the fairgrounds, let me know what week you guys will be there, because I'll be there up through the first week of November on the weekends, Friday and Saturday, working there from 7 to 10 on Fridays and 7 to midnight on Saturdays. So be sure to hit me up. Let me know if you guys are in the area. What else? I'm trying to think of what else I was gonna say. Oh, yeah. How many of you guys are excited for Super Showdown this weekend coming up? Because personally, I'm very excited. And I keep on getting this question, which is, who do you think is going to win between Undertaker and Triple H? And honestly, I don't know. Like, Triple H is good in his own right, and so is Undertaker, man. I'm a huge fan of both, so I can't really say. I mean, will this finally be Triple H's time to finally defeat The Undertaker and beat him once and for all? Could be. Could The Undertaker, go undefeated? Who knows? Like, it's definitely going to be a legendary match. So, in a way, I'm kind of glad that mom doesn't have a car yet. So, I can actually watch that match instead of working. So, like, for once, thank you, God, for not giving my mom my car yet. That way I can watch this match. Because, this match is definitely gonna be very, like, it's probably gonna, from what I've seen personally, just through social media alone, this is definitely gonna be the biggest match of the year for WWE entirely. Are two legends going at it one last time. Two of the biggest legends and professional WWE wrestling going at it one more time before they finally retire for good and get put into the Hall of Fame. So I'm definitely excited. I'm definitely excited for this matchup, man. Like I said, will Taker win? Will Triple H win? I don't know. I can't say because, like I said, they're both very good in their own respect. I know, right? Like, you guys gotta remember, I grew up in the 90s, so like, I grew up around a lot of the early wrestling myself, like with Hulk Hogan, Jerry the King Lawler, like a lot of the old school guys that we grew up with, like Booker T, Eddie Guerrero, Chris Benoit, like all the old school wrestlers, man, straight up love those guys. Hey, you too, man. You have a good day too, and good luck with work. Don't work too hard. I know, right? Like, I was literally born in 90s, so like I was raised around both 80s and 90s stuff. I was like right in that era of both generations, so like I can really relate to both sides. Like, I grew up on everything 80s and everything 90s. So, like, I'm like that guy that's in between both generations. Like, you want to talk 80s music? Let's talk whatever band you want to talk, like fucking Metallica or whatever. If you want to talk 90s? Let's talk Backstreet Boys, NSYNC. Boys to Men, Aaron Carter, like a lot of the old school cats. Hell, you want to talk 80s cartoons, man? Let's talk fucking Silk Thundercats. Freaking Smurfs, the original Scooby-Doo, man. Like, what's not to love about the 80s, man? They had some good stuff back then. And so did the 90s, not gonna lie. 90s and early 2000s were real good. Hell, I grew up on both Atari and Super Nintendo. Like, you know, my favorite freaking classic game of all time is Centipede. Along with, what is it? Not Galaga, but the one that's like Galaga, Space Invaders. I know, right? Like in the 80s and 90s, things were so much simpler back then. They really were. And believe me, I wish to God, like if I had a time machine right now, I would literally go back in time and stay in the 90s. Like I would not leave the 90s because back then it was so simple. I had so much fun as a kid back then. Like back then, yeah, I had a Super Nintendo and N64 and stuff like that. But 90% of the time, I was outside hanging out with my friends. Whenever your friends' bikes were over at your one friend's house, you knew that's where they were all at. So you fucking grabbed your bike and you ran over there. Or you grabbed your skateboard and you ran over there and said, "What's up?" And you guys hung out for 50 million hours on the weekend. Like, at least that's what I did. And hell, I was raised in the country most of my life. I was raised out in the freaking backwoods on the dirt roads of Washington State most of my life. So wherever my friends were at, I would always be right there because I would always see their bikes or their boards or whatever, and I'd automatically be over there. Or we'd be out riding around, raising hell on the dirt roads, having fun. without getting the cops involved. Like I was a bit of a hellion and a daredevil when I was growing up. Like I was a bit of a daredevil growing up, not gonna lie. Like I was that kid that would always climb trees and do crazy stuff. That was me to the T. Like if there was a tree and I could climb it, I was running up that bitch and climbing that thing. I know, right? Like, and it's sad. Like, what happened to you? And that's like one question I get all the time is like, what was life for you like growing up? For me, it was a lot simpler. And I mean, a lot simpler. Back then growing up, like you didn't, well, I mean, you had drugs, but that was mainly in the major cities, like in the big cities, like New York, like downtown New York, Detroit, stuff like that. That's where all that was. But back then, man, and this is completely true. Like, if you guys listen to Upchurch at all, who is actually a country music artist as well as a country hip hop artist, like if you guys listen to Upchurch, he's got some great music. If you haven't heard his music yet, check him out. He's got some amazing stuff. But like, I was watching one of his videos one day on Facebook, and he's totally right on this. Back then, all you had to really worry about back then was either, your buddy getting drunk and catching his boot on fire from being too drunk, or just getting complete. All it was really back then was like literally all it was is, oh God, what was it? Oh yeah, it was back then you only had three things really to worry about: whiskey, marijuana, beer. That's all you had to worry about back then. Now it's like everything's crazy. I mean, seriously, especially where I grew up, the most you had to worry about was your friend getting high and running into someone or running into a tree or whatever. And whatnot, or getting super drunk and catches boot on fire. Like that's all you had to worry about back then. But now it's like you got fucking kids losing their teeth by the time they're fucking in 11th grade, and it's sad. And what's sad is a lot of these music artists that are out there are glorifying being a dope head and being a pill popper and shit like that. And it's sad. But I mean, I completely agree with when people tell me that, things need to go back to the way they used to be. Like they really do. Like things need to go back to how they used to be instead of all this bullshit. Like, and a lot of people don't know this, but like, or just by looking at me, like a lot of people don't think that, that I'm a country boy because I live in the city, I do city-based stuff. But honestly, I'm a country boy at heart. Like, I fucking listen to the country music station all the time. Like, that's what I was raised on. Like, and it's funny, a lot of people think that, because I do photography and stuff, I do, city-based stuff, that I'm just another city slicker. Nah, dude. You get me out in the country, I'm having a fucking blast. Here in the city, ain't shit for me. Anyways, I can find 10 times more stuff to do out in the country than I could here in the city. Like out in the country, man, I can go hunting, fishing, climb trees, dig around, have fun, grab a four-wheeler and go fucking nuts. But here it's like I can't do a damn thing that I really want to do because of the fucking inner city laws, which is bullshit. I mean, the closest thing I have to the country is the fucking woods down here by the lake, and that's about it. Like those woods are basically my escape. Like that's my only little bit of country that I do have around here. I know a lot of people still don't get it, but I'm not at home in the woods. I'm at home in the country. You get me an open field, you get me a four-wheeler, you get me a dirt bike, I'm going fucking nuts. Hell, get me a fucking dune buggy and I'll fucking tear up some grass. Let's roll. Like when I was a kid, man, be safer. Like you could stay out at night now and have to worry about shit. Like I remember when I was a kid, I used to stay outside till like freaking 8, 9 o'clock at night, just having fun. Like that was me. Like I was that kid that would stay out till like 8, 9 o'clock at night, just playing baseball, riding dirt bikes, hanging out with my friends. Like that was me. I was that kid. But then fucking social media happened and basically sent everything all to hell. And that didn't help anything at all, except to make things worse. No offense to everybody on social media, and no offense. I know I sound kind of contradicting because I use social media for my work, for my career, for my job. I get that. But honestly, if I had my way, I'd be doing things the old-fashioned way with CDs, cassettes, flyers. Like, that's how I would do it. But unfortunately, like I said before, the music industry has changed so much. And cassettes are outdated. Nobody uses cassettes anymore. Nobody listens to CDs anymore. And it's sad. You just kind of got to go with it, which sucks. Like this, I'm that kid that like I love getting the CD. Like for me, it's like a piece of my childhood. Like I remember when I was a kid and I got the first ever, NSYNC and Backstreet Boys CDs for my birthday. And dude, from that moment I heard those two bands, I was hooked. Until NSYNC split, I was hooked. Backstreet Boys, they're still doing their thing. So shout out to Backstreet Boys for still continuing on. Much love, much to you guys. And a lot of people give me a hard time about the Backstreet Boys, but you guys gotta remember, I grew up with these guys as a kid, so these guys are part of my childhood, so obviously I'm gonna follow them. Like a lot of the older 90s, 80s bands, like those are the things that I listen to, along with some of, obviously the newer stuff, like Breaking Benjamin, Evanescence, Disturbed, Linkin Park, Suicide Silence, that kind of thing. But for the most part, I'm a 90s guy. All right, like these kids nowadays, they don't know how hard we had it. I had to carry around a freaking cassette player with my favorite playlist that week, for that whole week. Exactly. Like I remember like recording like a lot of my favorite bands growing up, like Backstreet Boys, Simple Plan, Evanescence, Disturbed. Like I remember recording bands when they were coming out and having that whole playlist for that entire week and just have my freaking headset on with a CD and CD in or a cassette in and just jamming out for that whole week and then get home and re-record my favorite songs right when I got home. Like whenever your song come on the radio and you knew what was coming on, you automatically you erase that tape, you put that bitch in, and you press that record button. There wasn't no skip or anything like that. Like you literally had to fast forward to your favorite song, then rewind, then fast forward and rewind, and then when the tape was done, you had to rewind it all the way back. I mean, dude, you're talking to a guy who grew up with VHSs. Like, dude, I have over 200 and something dollars in Disney VHS tapes. Yes, I'm a Disney guy. Love my Disney movies. Love Studio Ghibli. Shout out to Miyazaki. Or I should say, shout out to Hayao Miyazaki, the legend, the myth, the man, the brains behind Studio Ghibli and a lot of these really good anime movies like Kiki's Delivery Service. Castle in the Sky. I've been following that man's work since I was a kid when he first started making movies. Huge fan, seen all his movies up to date. I'm just waiting on the new set to come out so I can watch those. I don't have them on DVD yet, but I do plan to. And I did, this is a question that I did get asked just recently, which is an interesting question, which is, out of my childhood, what is my all-time favorite movie from the 80s, 90s, or early 2000s, as far as like good movies go? And man, and that was a tough one because like, I really had to think about that. But one of my personal favorite series that I grew up with would have to be the Air Bud movies. Like I grew up with the Air Bud movies, seen them all, love them all, huge fan. Like that's one of my favorite, Disney series growing up as a kid. Now, as far as cartoon movies go, like cartoon-based movies for movies in general for that time. Definitely Hayao Miyazaki's Kiki's Delivery Service because that was like the first anime-based movie I ever saw, and that's kind of what got me going in that stuff. Yes, I freaking weirded away. That's one of my personal favorites right there. And if you've not checked out Kiki's Delivery Service, definitely do it. It's a good movie. I highly recommend it. A funny movie too. It's very funny. Also, if you guys do have cable and you watch Nickelodeon at night, they actually brought back a lot of the old 90s cartoons that I grew up with, like Hey Arnold, Rocket Power, Rugrats, Doug. So I definitely check those out. They are bringing back Wild Thornberries, which is freaking awesome. I know, I'm making a lot of y'all feel old over here. Well, how do you think I feel? I'm 28. I'm just as old as you guys, so like it sucks. Getting old sucks. Just plain and simple. But yes, I do still watch old 90s, early 2000s. I watch all those old shows, early 80s. Silver Hawks, Dexter's Lab, Courage the Cowardly Dog, Scooby-Doo, He-Man, Masters of the Universe. Like, you're talking to a dude that grew up on a little bit of everything. So, like, it was. Right. Right, that's exactly how I feel. I'm like, dude, I'm 28 and I'm just like, dude, why can't I like why hasn't nobody invented a fucking time machine to go back in time yet? Like, why haven't they invented this shit? Like, y'all can invent the smartest artificial intelligence in the world that acts and speaks and looks and reacts just like a human. Like y'all can make an exact replica or an exact replication of a human, But yet, y'all motherfuckers can't build a time machine? Like, really? Y'all can build cyborgs, robots, artificial intelligence, but y'all don't have the brains to build a time machine? Like, come on, man, build a time machine. Because there are people like me that want to go back in time and relive our childhood without the school. Like, I would love to go back and visit the 90s without having to go back to school. Although going to school wouldn't be too bad, because that would kind of give me something to do. I know, right? And a lot of people think that I'm just like trying to relive my childhood by being stuck on this stuff. But it's like, dude, that's my childhood. How can I not be stuck on it? Like, dude, I grew up with freaking Hot Wheels, which I still collect to this day. Like, I grew up on freaking Jackie Chan Adventures, fucking Pokemon before it went out of control, fucking Yu-Gi-Oh before they had 50 million seasons, fucking the original Beyblade, freaking the Harry Potter movies, which I do have every single card from every freaking movie. I have the entire collection of every card put up. And no, I'm not selling it. That is a part of my fucking childhood. Like, and I've had 50 million people tell me that they, like, I've had people offer me hundreds of dollars for my collection. And it's like, no, I am not getting rid of the Harry Potter cards that I collected. I have every single card from every movie from when they were releasing the movies. From the very beginning to the last one, I have every single card. And no, I'm not getting rid of them. And yes, I do have the calendar too, like the Sorcerer's Stone calendar that they came out with. I do have those. I do plan on putting those up actually as soon as I can actually get a bigger room, or as soon as we can get that room cleared out of all those heavy ass boxes. And get my bedroom slash office set back up so I can do my work in there. Like, you guys are talking to a guy that grew up watching the Disney movie Brink, which is an old skating movie in the 90s. One of my all-time favorites too. Absolutely love that movie. I grew up on that, on the famous Jet Jackson. That's so weird. And That's So Weird was one of my personal favorites. Like, I still watch that to this day. And if you guys have not seen that yet, I will leave links for you guys to watch it. If you've not seen the TV show That's So Weird, dude, you need to watch it. It's fucking awesome. Like, I agree wholeheartedly, though. 100%. Like, they need to make a time machine so that people like us can go back in time and visit the 90s whenever the fuck we want. Like, that'd be freaking awesome. As a matter of fact, I actually, what I'm gonna do for you guys, I'm gonna do something that I'll probably wind up getting busted for, but I really don't give a shit. Let's see if I can. Some of you guys might recognize it, some of you might not, but this is the actual intro for that song. Right, this is the actual song intro for that show. It's actually a personal favorite of mine. I have it in a playlist.
Darkness down below.
In the darkness.
Now tell me if y'all remember this. Tell me if y'all remember this. Now tell me y'all don't remember that theme song. Like, that show was huge in the 90s. Right? Right, hey, I do the same thing all the time, especially for like the older Zelda games and shit. I always watch the old commercials. Those were some of the best ones. Like, those are some of the best ones, or some of the 90s based stuff. Now, I know y'all are gonna know this one.
Come on, it's the famous Jack Jackson!
Well, saving is the game. Silverstone is the man, secret agent status.
Now tell me y'all don't remember this. Now, how many of y'all remember this? Yes. Yes. Fucking yes. And believe me, I wish they would bring it back. And they do still have it up on YouTube. They still have the full series up there, which is fucking awesome. Now, I know you guys will know this one. This is actually from one of my all-time favorite movies growing up as a kid on Disney Channel. I swear to God, if y'all don't know it and you're from the 90s, what the fuck is wrong with you? What the fuck you been missing out on for the last decade, two, three, four decades?
When he's working late and she's stuck closing up, they're not going to get paid a penny of overtime because Mike DeWine joined a lawsuit that blocked overtime pay for 300,000 workers in Ohio just like them. And that's Mike DeWine for you.
Now tell me you guys don't wreck. I swear to God, if you don't know this, what is wrong with you?
Stargazing mega flash, you hit me like a cosmic blast. You're giving me a technicolor world, putting me in overdrive. Speed of light on so light. Could you be
now? Tell me, you guys, when the 90s don't remember this shit. Now, just pause it right there for a minute. How many of you guys from the 90s remember that? One of the biggest freaking movies of all time to come out of the late 90s, mid to late 90s, early 2000s. A good movie series. There's like two or three of them, I think. Yeah, I think there was like three of them. But if you guys know that song, post it in the comments. And as for you guys that are wanting to see That's So Weird, I will actually link the video to that here in just a moment for you guys. Yeah, it's kind of freezing up here. All right, some in the comments. But there you guys go. If you guys do want to watch That's So Weird, that is the link to the channel where you guys can watch the entire series, or at least some of the video clips. I know they have some of the actual, I know they have like the full series. I know that they do still have the full series up on YouTube. I actually watch it all the time. It's one of my personal favorites to go back and watch. So if you guys do want to watch That's So Weird and you haven't yet, there's the link for you guys. I'm about to hop off, do some vlogging, do some photos, and I'll see you guys in a little bit, man. Peace.